Does SMT make much difference with the new 5800X3D? Simultaneous multi-threading, that's AMD's name for it, hyper-threading for Intel, basically splitting the cores in half so they can work on two separate loads of work at the same time. It's interesting. In the past, we've tested this. Sometimes there's been benefits to turning it off, sometimes there's not. Let's get into it for this chip. So, as always, I've done this testing in Lawville, 317.1 for this one. We've done this on the main system, which has got the 5800X3D in, 3080, 32 gigs of RAM. What's happened really is that CRG have been tweaking their technology recently, their streaming tech stuff. But with 317.1, Invictus was here. So basically, you can't really tell anything from the game because there's just all sorts of stuff going on. Ships here. Convention centers there, it's all craziness, loads of players on the servers, so you can't really tell much. But now that that's all died down and we've just got a pretty plain 317.1 patch out, it seems as though CRG have made another leap forward in performance, at least in Lawville, at least in this testing that I've done here. So that's good news for a start. But the question, does SMT make much of a difference? And you'll see here, it basically loses a few frames. I wasn't really sure which way this was going to go because in the past we found that actually if you've got enough cores, turning it off can actually help. You can get slightly more performance. But in this case, that doesn't seem to be what's happening. It could just be that the engine now has been utilized to the point with all these extra frames, these high frame rates, that actually the game, although it doesn't need more than 8 cores, it maybe benefits from the 8 cores and 16 threads. Maybe the engine is getting to the point where actually it will utilize extra cores. At some point, I'd love to do a proper retest. I did a video in the past looking at how many cores and threads you really need for the game. But if AMD were to release a 5900X 3D with a 3D cache technology, that would be really interesting because then that's a 12-core, 24-thread CPU. You can then step down and turn off a load of cores and see how many cores does the game really need. But with this, because it's only got 8 cores, 16 threads, you can't really do the testing that you'd want to. So hopefully, I think probably more realistically, that's going to be the AMD 7000 series. They're going to come out with some 3D cache chips at some point for that. Obviously, Intel will come back with their next 13th gen CPUs as well. So that's probably for another CPU. Can't really do it with this one. But that probably is what might be going on here, is just that the game actually does use those extra, it does use the threading rather than just being the single core. So it's not much, but there's no real reason for my testing here that you would want to turn off SMT. But I'd recommend whatever CPU you've got, because there has been cases in the past where it has been actually better to turn hyper-threading or SMT off. Potentially do this testing yourself. Just do a load of runs, average out the FPS with SMT or hyper-threading on, and then go in and do the same, SMT off. Do a load of runs, average them out and see, because it will depend on the CPU that you've got. So that's enough for this one. I will see you soon. Bye.